The Antonio Project present IMO Classification of Gas Carrier Part 2.
Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. This video is the continuation of my previous video about IMO Classification of Gas Carrier, and this is Part 2. As previously discussed, there are two types of gas carrier. One is independent tank, type A, type B, and type C. And second is integral tank, membrane type. The development and improvement of the liquefied gas carrier is running fast. For the example, are as follow. New tank type A such as Torji LNT A box. For type B, MHI Prismatic, built by Mitsubishi Heavy Industry. HHI Lock Bundle, built by Hyundai Heavy Industry. For type C, Multi Lock and Prismatic. And for membrane, Kogas KC1, built by Korean Gas. And then HHI HC1, built by Hyundai Heavy Industry. And SHI SGA, built by Samsung Heavy Industry. The purpose of new tank type development are as follow. First, reducing the cost of building, such as the material cost, working time, and royalty cost. And second, improvement to reducing the boil-off rate or BOR, fuel efficiency, and so on. Anyway, in this video, I just share about the most common types of gas carrier. What is next type of gas carriers? Let's check out my video. Oh, wait a minute. Before we continue to watch my video, if you don't mind, please subscribe my channel. And if you think that my video is useful, please click like and share button. Your subscription will speed up my idea to create more videos, and the more you like and share, the more people will top up their knowledge. Anyway, subscription, like, and share is very easy and it is free. By doing that, it means that you just give a tiny charity to others and huge support to my work. So, let's check out my video. Let's go.
Independent tank type B, spherical or MOS type. This type of cargo containment system developed by Norwegian Kvaerner MOS, a design of tank to transport LNG at cryogenic temperatures with pressure around the atmospheric pressure. The spherical tanks of this type of carrier are generally produced in aluminium or 9% nickel steel. The sphere is welded to a steel skirt attached to the sphere's equator using special extrusion process. The skirt is stiffened in the upper part by horizontal rings and the lower part by vertical corrugated stiffeners. The skirts transmit the weight of the tank and cargo to the lower hull. It allows the sphere to contract and expand with minimum load transfer to the hull structure. Since they are anchored to the ship's double hull using the steel skirt with a thermal brake made from a special alloy. Insulation is fitted to the outside shell of the sphere, but no secondary barriers is regarded as necessary across the upper part. However, below the sphere, an aluminium drip tray together with splash plate provides secondary protection for the hull. The secondary barrier must be designed to contain the cages for a given period, usually 15 days, requiring continuous monitoring to detect leakages from the primary barrier. Because of the enhanced design factors, A type B tanks requires only a partial secondary barrier in the form of a drip tray. The whole space in this design is normally filled with dry inert gas or dry air, providing the necessary inert void atmosphere if the vapor detection system indicates some cargo leakage. A protective steel dome is used to cover the primary barrier above deck level, and an insulation layer is applied over the outside surface of the primary barrier. Following is the spherical or MOS type cargo containment structure. Let's dig deeper inside of the cargo tank by peeling off one by one of the containment structural part. It will be started from inside of the spherical tank. Cargo pump tower or pipe tower is the tower connecting south pole and north pole of the sphere. The various instruments are fitted inside of the pipe tower in cargo tank, which absorb a contraction and expansion of cargo tank depending on the atmospheric temperature in the tank. Drip tray or drip pan. A space is divided into 9 compartments by buffer plates, which acts as anti-sloshing hole and extended surface for heat transmission. Cargo pump. The cargo pumps are submerged type, electric motor driven, single state, centrifugal types. Usually, there are 2 sets installed inside of the tank. Spray pump. The spray pumps are submerged type, electric motor driven, single state, centrifugal types. Bottom filling line for filling up the tanks from bottom part. Tank insulation or splash barrier. Polyurethane or polystyrene foam with thickness of 250 mm to reduce the boil off to a minimum. Tank insulation cover to cover of both polyurethane insulation surface made of aluminium foil. Cargo tank shell or primary barrier. Cargo tanks are constructed using welded thick plates of aluminium alloy with thickness ranging between 29 and 57 mm and the usual is of 50 mm. Skirt or spear supporter. The support of the spears are provided by equatorial rings to transmit the loads to the hull using stainless steel skirts with circular shape. Outer shell or weather cover, made of steel and the main purpose for tank and insulation weather protection. Ballast water tank used for vessel stability by filling with ballast water and to provide protection to the cargo tanks in case of a collision or grounding. Double bottom pipe passage used for laying ballast pipe and valves and to provide protection to the cargo tanks in case of a grounding. Cargo hold space used for holding any cargo in the event of cargo leakage and for inspection or maintenance. Rupture disc film of the bimetal type that is open or burst when the liquid liquid reaches the disc. Annular space. Nitrogen gas is continuously supplied to the insulation space from the end to bleed line in order to ensure the adequate path in the insulation space for the gas detection system. A special feature of the spherical design is the capability of emergency discharge by overpressurizing the tanks in case of pump failures. To do this, the safety relief valves will be closed off, allowing vaporized LNG to build up to a pressure of approximately 2.0 kg per square centimeter. The development of new generation of LNG ship by Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, defining evolutions of the Vanner MOS spherical tank. With features of pivot-shaped continuous water cover for the MOS spherical tanks that is integrated with ship's hull in lieu of a conventional hemispherical cover. This new configuration allegedly enables greater structural efficiency size and weight economies, resulting not only in improvement in fuel consumption as well as in operating economy, but also in enhancement in terms of compatibility with LNG terminals and maintainability.
Independent tank type C, cylindrical and bi-loop type. Type C independent tanks, also referred to as pressure vessels, are tanks meeting pressure vessel criteria and having a design vapor pressure not less than 2 bar. In accordance to OCIMF, these tanks are usually of spherical or cylindrical geometry pressure vessels with design pressure higher than 500 kilopascal or 4 bars. If cylindrical, they may be vertically or horizontally mounted. These tanks are always used for semi-pressurized and fully pressurized gas transporters. Type C tanks are designed and built to according pressure vessel codes and, as a result, can be subjected to accurate stress analysis. Consequently, no secondary barrier is required and hold spaces can be filled with either inner gas or dry air. If the carrier is pressurized, normal air can be used. If the vessel is typical fully pressurized with the cargo transported at ambient temperature, the tanks may be designed for a maximum working pressure of about 1900 kilopascal or about 18 bars. For a semi-pressurized vessel, the cargo tanks and associated equipment are designed for a working pressure of approximately 600 to 800 kilopascal or 5 to 7 bars and vacuum of 140 kilopascal or 0.3 bars. Usually, the steel applied for the semi-pressurized vessels are capable of withstanding transport temperature of minus 48 degrees Celsius for LPG or minus 104 degrees Celsius for ethylene, which can be used for transport LPG. An improved design buy is made intersecting pressure vessels or bi-loop type tanks, which may be designed with taper at the forward end of the ship. Following is the structural design of C-type gas carrier, bi-loop tank and cylindrical tank. The structure are as follows: outer skin, insulation made of polyurethane foam, and then tank shell.
Deep well cargo pump centrifugal pump type. Cargo pump motor explosion proof type.
Swash bulkhead longitudinal or transverse non-tight bulkhead fitted in tank to reduce the surge of the liquid when the ship rolls and pitches, and consequently to reduce the dynamic impact or sloshing forces of the liquid on the surrounding structure. These cargo tanks are constructed to a minimum design pressure, and they are not used for LNG transportation purpose, except in cases this cryogenic is carried as fuel or as bunker vessel. The advantage of Type C is the possibility to handle the BOG and handle increasing of the cargo tank pressure. When compared to Type A and Type B, this carrier present some disadvantages due to higher containment weight and lower effective utilization of void spaces.
Integral tank membrane type.
Integral tank or non-cell supporting membrane tanks are otherwise surrounded by the double hull carrier structure. Membrane tanks are non-cell supporting tanks consisting of thin layers or membrane supported through insulation by adjacent hull structure. The membranes are designed to compensate thermal effects without significant stresses. In order to control the effects of ship structure from a potential leakage of cryogenic liquids, the code requires that a secondary barrier is to be provided. The double membrane design consists of one or two thin layers of stainless steel or alloy steel of high nickel content with thicknesses ranging between 0.7 and 1.2 mm. It is capable to contain a hydrostatic load 25,000 cubic meter of LNG, but uses the vessel structural support. The two membranes are separated by a thin layer of perlite, plywood, and insulating polyurethane foam. Following is the structure of membrane type LNG cargo containment. Cover dam is the empty space to separate cargo tanks from other compartments. Cover dam to be heated using glycol water heating system to prevent the temperature of the cover dam and liquid dome from decreasing below 5 degrees Celsius. To be maintained, the temperature inside cover dam at approximately plus 20 degrees Celsius, preventing the steel to reach possible brittle fracture temperature. Ballast water tank used for vessel stability by filling with ballast water and to provide protection to the cargo tanks in case of a collision or grounding. Pipe duct used for laying ballast pipe and valves and to provide protection to the cargo tanks in case of grounding. Secondary barrier and secondary insulation. Primary barrier and primary insulation. Membrane sheath.
Cargo pump. The cargo pumps are submerged type, electric motor driven, single state, centrifugal types. Usually, there are two sets installed inside of the tank. Spray pump. The spray pumps are submerged type, electric motor driven, single state, centrifugal types.
Bottom filling line. Cargo pump discharging line. Spray pump discharging line. Top filling line. Safety valve line. Deflection plate for vapor line.
Membrane type GTT number 96 consists of a structure made of plywood filled with perlite in order to keep tightness and insulation. Its design is composed of two inferior membranes, primary barrier and secondary barrier, and linked to the double hull tanks to an inferior tube. The insulation is 530 mm thick and it's constructed with perlite. The boxes are connected to the double hull by the means of couplers. Membrane tank GTT Mark III consists of two layers of reinforced polyurethane foam separated by triplex in order to set an insulation device. Primary membrane made of nickel chromium stainless steel and a triplex for secondary membrane. The triplex is a composite material made of aluminium glass fiber. The insulation is reinforced polyurethane foam panels. These panels are linked together with top bridge pads and bonded to the double hull. Gas transport and technique gas are merged in one company, whose latest containment system, the Combined System No. 1, CS1, incorporates features from the existing GT No. 96 as well as of the TG Mark III systems. CS1 design uses a primary infar membrane linked to the double hull tanks to infar tubes and a secondary triplex membrane.
I think that's all my video about
IMO classification of cash carrier. If you have any additional information or advice, please leave it at below comments. Thank you for watching my video. Your contribution by subscribe my channel is highly appreciated. See you in my another video. Bye-bye. The Antonio Project.